What if I told you that there's a scale so unimaginably small, it might represent the fundamental limit of the universe's fabric? Meet the Planck length, a mind-bending concept rooted in quantum mechanics and general relativity. It's roughly 1.6, 1 times 10, to the power of minus 35 meters, far smaller than anything we can currently measure. But why does this incredibly tiny distance hold such profound significance in physics? Here's the deal. When you take Planck's constant from quantum mechanics, the speed of light from relativity, and Newton's gravitational constant, and combine them mathematically, the result gives you the Planck length. It's not just a number. It represents a scale where our current understanding of physics breaks down. At this minuscule frontier, the smooth spacetime described by Einstein's general relativity collides violently with the quantum fuzziness of particles and waves. Essentially, it's the pixel size of the universe, assuming spacetime itself is digital rather than continuous. Why does this matter? The Planck length hints at where we need a quantum theory of gravity, something that unifies quantum mechanics and general relativity. Physicists suspect that at distances shorter than the Planck length, spacetime might dissolve into a foam-like structure often called Planck foam. This chaotic state might consist of untamed fluctuations in energy and geometry, concepts that existed at the very dawn of the universe, just fractions of a second after the Big Bang. Interestingly, if you were to squeeze the mass of the universe into a volume equivalent to the cube of the Planck length, you'd create a black hole. That's because the energy density at this scale is ludicrously high, far exceeding anything imaginable. Quantum gravity theories, like string theory and loop quantum gravity, are attempting to decode the bizarre rules of physics at this scale. Both theories explore whether space-time could emerge from even more fundamental components, perhaps vibrating strings or interconnected loops. Now, why can't we just build a microscope to zoom in on the Planck scale and see what happens? Well, here's the kicker. To probe such tiny distances, we'd need particle collision energies so fantastically high that the very act of investigation would create a gravitational singularity, a black hole. This means, at least with our current tools, nature hides these secrets behind an impenetrable veil. The implications of the Planck length are staggering. If space-time is quantized, as this concept suggests, then every step we take, every thought we think, and even the passage of time itself unfolds on an unimaginably tiny grid. It also challenges our intuitions about continuity, infinity, and reality itself, key topics for mathematics, philosophy, and physics alike. Physicists continue to push theoretical and experimental boundaries, hoping to glimpse the mysterious scaffold of the cosmos. Could the Planck length be the universe's ultimate brick? Or might there be an even deeper structure beyond it? That's the open frontier we're grappling with today. If you're intrigued by big cosmic ideas packed into short, accessible stories, or longer explorations that dive even deeper, subscribe to Hyperfocus. Together, we'll cut through the fluff and tackle the toughest questions in science, physics, and technology.